Hello everyone. Today we will start from Unit 2, the basics of C# and console applications in C#. Our topics are namespace, writing program with C# and console input and output in C#. First topic, namespace. Namespace is a grouping of logically related identifiers, classes and types, etc. Namespace is used to avoid conflicts with the elements of an unrelated code which have the same names. All classes and types of .NET FCL are organized in namespaces. How to create a namespace? First of all, here syntax is mentioned. It is namespace is keyword which is written first, space namespace name must be written. After that, we need to write curly braces. Here we have given the example namespace GTU. In curly bracket, class is mentioned, that is name student, and public static void main. Here console.writeline is written. Console is a class and writeline is a method. Console is a class which is used under a system namespace. We will see later how we can write line in input and output functions. So whatever the written in write line in double braces, it will directly print on output. Here I have written this is student class in write line method, so it will be printed. In namespace GTU, we have two different classes, that is named student as well as subject. In subject class, we have mentioned our main method. As we know that wherever we have written main, from there our execution will be started. So in main function, we have written a console class with the method writeline. In that I have written this is a subject class. So each method is ended with semicolon. Now, how we can create a namespace? So first of all, we have written keyword namespace. After that space, we have written here GTU. GTU is nothing but a name of namespace. So here I can say I have created GTU namespace along with two different classes, that is named student and subject. Student class contain a main. For example, it is a write line method. This is student class statement. And in subject class, main method will also, main function will also contain the write line method with the line, this is subject class. Next, how to use a namespace? Here, with the keyword using, we can use the namespace. I have created GTU namespace, and here with using keyword, I have used that namespace GTU. It is written before a program code. So it is always the first line of our code example with the using keyword. So here two namespaces are used. First is GTU and second is system. Along with after namespace, we will write a class name. After the class, we will write any method. And inside the method, we can use any functions. Now, here in class result, we have created an object of subject class. You can see here, we have taken subject class, and here to use this subject class, we need to call the GTU namespace. So here we called using keyword GTU, and we have created object as of class subject. Now, I can use any method of this subject class with this program. So here it is a code which represents how we can use namespace. Next, alias of namespace. Alias of namespace is used for conveniency of writing purpose. Means what? If I can use any system namespace, its Windows class and its win method, Okay, then I need to write system.windows. or any other classes like button. So I need to call system.windows.button. But each and every time, if I don't want to repeat the same statement, so I can use, say, this short abbreviation win. This keyword win I have created for replacement of system.windows. So wherever I need to write system.windows, I can only use this win keyword. It is user defined, but you can write anything in place of win. So syntax of alias is using, you need to write alias name. It is user defined, any word. And here by equals to, you can write a path, single namespace, or a sequence of namespace. So here system.windows, in place of, you can only write win keyword. So here you can see inside the class test, I have written win.splashScreen. But if I don't want to write win, I can write here system.windows.splashScreen. Here object is created. So it is a purpose of alias of namespace. Nested namespace. Nested namespace is used where we have multiple namespace inside another namespace. Nested namespace is allowed in .NET, like system namespace contains system.web namespace. Here I have three number of namespaces: parent, child, and grandchild. So if I need to call any method inside the class which is inside a grandchild, I need to call that class like parent.child.grandchild.that particular class name. So it is called the nesting of namespace, in which the namespace is inside another namespace. Now namespace is used to logical collection of code. It is nothing but used to avoid the conflicts between same class name. Here we have written the first program in C# language with the concept of namespace. Here I have used system namespace, which is built-in namespace, by using keyword using. Namespace student is also here, which is also called a user defined namespace. Okay, it is a built-in. We have not created this namespace system, but here I am creating a namespace students, so I can write any code inside the student. If I want to call this code in another program, so I can use using student there. So here inside a student namespace, we have class that is named ABC, and in ABC class we have a public static void main statement. In this main function, we have written console.writeLine, which print hello world. After that, we have written here console.readLine. In next program, we will see what is the meaning of writeLine and readLine. But whatever we can print, whatever we want to print on the screen, we need to write inside writeLine method. So first we need to learn which are the input and output functions to understand this program. So it is our next topic, that is console input and output in C#. Here we have basically five functions for input and output. You can see readLine is used for accept a string format in input string. Read is used to accept a string format from input string, but it can read any single character. It is used for whole string. ReadKey is used to wait program for a key space and prevent the screen from running and closing quickly. Means after, like you were writing in getch in C language, as well as same way you can write readKey in your programming .NET language. Write function is used for printing output string, and writeLine is used to print output string in a new line. Whenever you will use write method, it will not send the cursor in next line, but if we used right line, it will print a data in new line. So we will do its program. First of all, Visual Studio is open for it. Microsoft Visual Studio 10 I'm using here. I have created one program, that is Hello World. You are creating new one, then you may go File, New, Project. Here I will choose all compliant languages, but I will choose Visual C Sharp. In that, console application is selected and you can press OK. So you can see here, built-in namespaces are written here. It is custom namespace, that is user-defined namespace. By default, whatever your project name, it will be directly written in as your namespace. Here, inside the namespace, class program is written. And in this program, your static void function is written. Now, I'll print Hello World. So I have written this program priorly. So I'll open that project that is named Hello World. Whenever I will open this Hello World, you can see namespace Hello World is written as I have given that project name Hello World. Inside this namespace, main function and class program is there. I have written console.writeLine Hello World. So whatever I will print in this writeLine method in double quotes, it will directly in console output. So here you can see our output will be Hello World. It is printed and screen is not statically stopped in our output. So for this, we need to write console.readLine. If I write this console.readLine right, we can see our output. It is Hello World. So whenever I will press any key, then only output will be gone. So to see a static screen, our output in our window, we need to write console.readLine. Here you can also write any read key or read function only. So you can see it is your first program to print Hello World on your output screen. Next is a program of printing input and output functions. So for that, I will open a project that is named input output functions. Here you can see I have created one method that is inside a class program that is named main function. Here integer number variable is taken. For this num, I'll store any value inside this num variable and print on output. So for printing purpose, I have written console.writeLine, kindly enter any value of num. This statement will directly printed on our output. Then whatever the value which is written or entered by user, it will be stored in this num variable. So by fetching or getting purpose, we will write a method readLine. So console.readLine will get any value and it will be converted in integer, because the default all values are stored in string format. So other than string data, if you want to capture from the user, you need to convert into specific data type. So here I have converted into integer and directly stored in num variable. Now I'll print this num data. So console.writeLine. In curly braces, I have written 0 and 1, and the value of num is n num. Here, you can see the 0 mentioned for this statement, which is written firstly after comma, and 1 will print this variable's value, which is written after another comma. So the values, number of values you need to print, it will be written from 0, 1, 2, and its respective data value will be printed after separating comma. So here, 0 will print the value of normies, and curly braces 1 will print the value which is stored in norm. It is like percentage in percentage D, which we are using in language C. So you can see its output. First, it will print kindly enter the value of norm. Now I'll enter 6 value. So my output will be the value of norm is 6. This line is printed by curly bracket 0 and 6. That is the value which I have stored in norm variable. It is printed here. So you can say it is a program of basic input and output. Now, console input and output functions which we have seen in program, that is readline, read, readkey, write and writeline. And we have seen this program, how to create a first program and how we will write this input output code which we have seen practically. So thank you everyone.